Christine is a pink-loving girly girl.
Pink soap, pink Ugg boots.
Of course, it's pink, like everything else in my room.
Who wants people to take her seriously.
Why are you laughing?
Eddie is a pop culture fanatic.
I joined an Ashley Simpson fan club. Is it my David Archuleta door?
Who wants to put himself on the social map at school. Abby is a total tomboy. Who's tired of being seen as one of the guys. Three high school classmates who have nothing in common, except for one ultimate life-changing goal.
I want to be
made into a hip-hop dancer.
Today, they'll get their chance. The stakes are the highest they've ever been. Our kids will compete live in front of everybody they know, their classmates, family, friends, and hip-hop superstar, Soulja Boy, at a huge event in their hometown of Boston.
I've sacrificed a lot already.
What have you sacrificed? You don't do after school.
The hell do you think you're wearing on stage?
Not spandex.
Hey, Christine!
Tell him to shut the hell up.
Who will be crowned the hip-hop champion?
Good job losing $10,000!
This is a made like you've never seen before.
Kiss my ass.
Yeah?
It's the biggest MADE competition ever, the head-to-head hip-hop challenge. But last 4 weeks, three high school kids have been training hard to become hip-hop dancers. And today, right here, they will battle it out for the grand prize of $10,000. Which one of these kids has been made into the best hip-hop dancer? Later on in the show, they'll have to face their biggest challenge yet, performing a dance routine on this stage in front of our audience filled with the kids from their school, Winthrop High, along with family, friends, and our three celebrity judges. Chris Judd is in the building. Lori-Ann Gibson. And of course, the boy needs no introduction, hip-hop superstar, Soulja Boy. That's not all. Soulja Boy will perform his hit, Bird Walk, later on, right here on this stage. But right now, let's meet the three kids.
My name's Christine. I love cheerleading, but I'm not really good at it.
Wait, I have a question again.
She tries, but it's just not there.
I'm not really good at, like, balancing myself, so I do fall a lot.
My name's Abby. I'm noticed for being the tomboy jock.
I won this year for high school softball.
She's better than most of the boys in our high school.
The only time I'm the center of attention is on the softball team.
I joined an Ashley Simpson fan club, so I got a free necklace with it, which I wore all last year. My name is Eddie, the kid who's obsessed with celebrities.
He's known as the guy that likes Ashley Simpson a lot and David Archuleta.
So my David Archuleta door, I decided to put my two favorite people together into one.
Every girl should have makeup, and if she doesn't, then I don't know what to say about that.
Christine's so pink.
Abby is nothing pink.
She's the most manly one of the group.
I think people judge me just for my athleticism. I just want to change my image and change the outlook that boys have on me.
I'm not active because I'm lazy.
Good morning, Viking.
Hi, can I have a cab to 60 in Enfield? School's not that far away from me. I mean, I could walk there in 10 minutes, but I'd rather take a cab than walk. My typical day at school is pretty much me by myself in the hallways just to get to class, because when I'm around a lot of people, I become uncomfortable. I'm in my own little world sometimes.
A lot of people don't respect me because they just think of me as an annoying little preppy girl. They don't take me seriously.
Her personality is kind of like sort of a ditzy cheerleader.
I'm gonna be a philosopher.
Philosopher.
They all think it's so funny, but I'm so much more than that, but they really have no idea.
I want to be a little bit more outgoing, more confident with myself. Not so scared of what people might think of me.
I wish that I could change my self-confidence because I have little of that in other areas of life rather than athletic.
I want to get people to respect me more and take me more seriously. So that's why.
I want to be made into a hip-hop dancer.
Hip-hop dancer.
Hip-hop dancer. I want to be made into a hip-hop dancer.
That's something that just jiggles around.
Right? No, they don't just jiggle around.
You took all those dance lessons when you were a kid. Oh, no, you didn't.
What made you think of this? What made you say, I want to do this?
Yeah, hip-hop's awesome, and, like, nobody else can do those moves. Like, you want to be able to.
Is that hip-hop? Yeah,
there you go.
Dad does it.
What kind of songs?
You know that radio station you don't like me to listen to because it's all rap music?
Mm-hmm.
It's stuff like that.
What?
Like what?
Hip-hop dancing, like, helps people express themselves and perform independently.
It kind of sounds weird to me. I don't know.
This is something I really want. Can't you, like, not question me and just support me?
I want to be made into a hip-hop dancer.
Oh, what? Want to play hockey. Sports is good for you.
I think hip-hop is safer than hockey.
Oh, that's why I see people that were bouncing off the walls or something on TV. I don't know what hip-hop is.
Don't you remember Vanilla Ice or whatever?
Oh, Vanilla Ice, isn't that the one that faked it? No, that was Willie Manili.
Do you think you're going to be able to do that?
I can try to do it.
And come out in one piece?
Maybe when David Archuleta goes on tour, I can be a backup dancer.
That's a lot of work, boy, but that's up to you, whatever you want to do.
Nice!
I want to be made into a hip-hop dancer.
You can't even do the worm.
I can do the worm, okay? Can't do it forward.
Do something off the floor.
I wouldn't know. I wouldn't know how to start. I need some music. I need music.
No, Eddie.
Yo, that's my signature move.
Be made into a hip-hop dancer.
You gotta be joking.
Why are you laughing?
You think you're good at dancing?
Yeah,
you're
saying I don't think I go dancing. Like,
stop!
I think you should stick with cheerleading.
I am so weak.
Let's go.
Ow.
So Eddie, do you know anything in dancing? Like, do you know how to, like, do any moves?
No.
I just gotta, like, blow off his maid coach and be like, you know what, I don't wanna do this.
I just think, like, you kind of push it aside sometimes.
Look at
it. Roll your eyes. You know I'm right. Don't roll your eyes.
I won't make up.
That's going to bite you in the ass, Eddie.
I think you'll do really good, though.
Just like, put your heart and soul.
I might resist at first, but I'll do it. I'll get work done.
That's Abby, Eddie, and Christine. Now, I met them 4 weeks ago at Winthrop High in front of a lot of these guys here in the audience, and we saw them dance, and boy, were they terrible. You guys agree? Yeah. All right, let's take a look at that very first day at Winthrop. I talked to the principal at Winthrop High, and we called a surprise assembly for the whole entire school. Our kids had no idea what was about to hit them.
Winthrop High School, make some noise. Today, we're gonna have a lot of fun. There are 3 students in this audience that have a dream to become hip-hop dancers. Let's meet our contenders. Where's Christine? Come on up. Abby. And Eddie. What's up, Abby? How are you? Good? Performed in front of an audience this big?
No.
Never ever. Can you see where I'm going with this?
I don't want to.
Well, actually, the first task of MADE starts right now. Right here. This is big. You've got to dance for a little bit. The music's gonna kick in. You're one step closer to getting MADE. Give it up for Abby.
Do I have to?
Yep. Comes next. Signature move. Keep it going. You have to keep going. It's time for one more person. Christine. You know what happens now, right?
No.
Yes. Make some noise. To put you out of your misery, right? Yeah, that was pretty painful. All right. These guys here, your friends, your classmates, your teachers weren't the only ones watching you. Your three coaches are here as well. Make some noise for the coaches. Sam, Cece, Cedric, welcome. These aren't any old hip-hop coaches. They've all appeared in MADE before.
Cedric Crow coached Abby, the churchy good girl and fencing fanatic, onto her school's hip-hop step team.
Crowd's not gonna feel it if you don't feel it.
And now he'll try his luck with Eddie. Cece Kelly gave goofy and self-conscious Hallie the confidence to break it down in front of her whole school.
I want you to add some funk into it, child!
Now she'll attempt to work her magic on Abby. Sam Renzetti took Marie from bland bookworm to bold leader while having her form her very own dance crew.
The more you overdo it, the less stupid you'll look.
And now he'll have his hands full with Christine.
Here's how it works. You guys can be going head to head in just 4 weeks' time. You're gonna have to perform a solo dance. You're gonna be judged. And not only do you get the crown, the winner of MADE, you also get to win $10,000. So, a big thank you to our kids, our coaches. They're one step closer to getting MADE. Winthrop High School, thank you very much.
Christine has, like, the most work ahead of her. Like, I don't think she's got so much talent, no offense to her. I think Eddie's gonna win, hands down.
I think Abby's gonna win because she can pick up on stuff really easily.
I think that Abby's gonna win.
I think it's gonna be Eddie.
Christine did the worst out of all three.
Christine did
Definitely
the worst.
Christine did the worst.
She just did the worst.
Why did you want to choose hip-hop?
I think it takes a lot of confidence.
Do you not think you have confidence?
I don't at all. Nobody supports me, like what we just witnessed.
After that reaction, how'd that make you feel?
I was upset because I'm pretty nice to people.
Does that make you want to prove them wrong?
Yeah.
So why hip-hop?
I want to do hip-hop for the whole thing about being able to come out of my shell. You know, dancing in front of people is going to be a big change to me.
As far as dance, what do you do?
I go to school dances, but I'm normally the one who's sitting waiting for the dance to be over.
So why hip-hop dancing?
I want to be viewed differently, obviously, more of like a girly girl. And I want like guys' attention.
How do you think hip-hop is going to make you be like that?
It's like graceful, but it's like breakdancing in a graceful way.
We've got 4 weeks. That's it. If I do come down hard, it's all for you.
I'll do what you want, but I feel like if you just start off as an asshole, I'll probably want to do the opposite.
In 4 weeks, we're going to accomplish musicality, coordination, a whole lot of attitude, a whole lot of ego. We can't waste any time, period.
You have other obligations, right?
I have cheering all the time.
So how do you think that's going to affect us going forward?
I don't think my coach is going to like that.
Well, there's a new coach in town.
I don't expect you to win. I know you're going to win. We have tunnel vision, and it's going straight to the money.
That's a lot of money. What do you plan on doing with $10,000?
Recently, my mom was diagnosed with lung cancer. $10,000 could help just being able to pay off the bills for what she needs.
Do you want to win the 10 Gs?
Yes, I do.
Let's go. Let's rock and roll. Sam, I'm going to win.
I'm going to win.
Not only does she have to become a hip-hop dancer, she has to turn her confidence all the way around, and now we have to get everyone's respect.
Let's do this. Break. Seeing Abby on stage, she was definitely not that good at all, but that's all going to change in 4 weeks.
All right, man, let's go. I didn't see a hip-hop dancer. I just saw, I saw a mushy little kid. Having a kid that doesn't do any physical activity is going to be hard.
That was a tough first day for Christine. Now, 4 weeks later, I'm here with Christine's friend Amanda. Welcome.
Welcome, thanks.
Are you excited to see Christine tonight?
I'm wicked excited.
Okay, when we first caught up with her at the MADE coach meeting, a lot of people booed her. Why was that?
I think it's because she's a cheerleader and everyone hates cheerleaders, supposedly.
Okay, okay. Did you get a chance to speak to her afterwards? How was she feeling?
She felt so embarrassed. She was wicked upset. She just didn't know, like, what to do, and she was afraid, like, for the final performance that everyone would boo her again.
Okay, well, I don't think that's going to happen tonight. Thank you very much. Cheers for coming. All right, it's obvious. Christine, Abby, and Eddie have a lot to prove. After the break, we're following them inside their first dance lesson. Stay tuned, because the battle has just begun. To a special edition of MADE, the head-to-head hip-hop challenge. We have three wannabe hip-hop dancers who are trying to change their lives and win $10,000 in the process. Let's take a look at our three MADE kids hitting the studio with their coaches for the very first time.
Ah, yeah.
I am at the dance studio with my MADE coach, Cedric, and I'm pretty stoked to start.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I think Sam's really gonna laugh at me, to be completely honest, because I really can't dance.
Commitment's number one.
Hey, girly, do not bend these knees.
Effort is number two.
Jeez! I cut myself. You need to shave your legs.
And motivation is number three. Hold it, go a little bit lower. There you go, hold it.
Hold it. I'm gonna cry.
Here we go.
Hang on.
Boom, boom. Ah.
Like.
Turn. Ooh, sorry. No bounds on that one.
No balance for real.
Jump it harder. One, two,
six. Terrible. It's different.
And up.
I feel it in my neck a little bit. Kind of painful.
It wasn't horrible. You know, we definitely have a lot to work on.
She pushes me, and that's good for a coach to push you.
Five. Stop looking down at your feet.
I don't think Cedric was that hard. I mean, I think it could have been harder.
I know this is our first time, but I'm expecting so much from you.
I know, like, a lot of people were really negative to you yesterday, and they're really disrespectful, but I want to change that. Assignment one, what I want you to do is go up to 10 people.
Oh, no.
Okay.
And do what?
I just want you to ask them, why did you boo me
at the assembly? Oh, no, come on.
You know what I mean? Considering it's the first lesson, I'm giving her a little bit of a break, okay, with her complaining, but eventually it's gonna have to stop.
a.m. little covert operation. Doing some, bring a little hip hop to Mayberry right now. I'm gonna go wake him up.
Good morning. How are you doing this morning?
Fine.
Awake, I see.
Yeah, my sister's still sleeping though.
Let's get ready for school.
Taking cabs is kind of lazy, and I'm not gonna have you lazy. So from this point on, we're gonna walk to school. Today, I'm walking with you.
Do what you gotta do, I'll wait for you. He is no joke with this dude.
David Archuleta, huh?
First thing I turn on, David Archuleta.
You all set? So this is your walk to school?
Yeah.
Why didn't you do this before? I mean, because it doesn't seem so bad.
I was like, I might as well just take a cab.
Yeah.
So
the brisk walk wakes your body up, gets your blood going.
All right, let's go in school.
When you're walking, I want you to have that same confidence like when you're dancing next to me.
Shoulders down, little pimp in your walk. Eddie. We like that, we like that.
You always sit here, right? This is your spot?
Yeah.
Not today. You need to go and sit at a table where people don't know you. You want me to pick the table? I see a bunch of dudes over there look like jocks.
No. If you bring me to the jock table, I'm gonna turn around.
Excuse me, gentlemen. May we join you right quick? Have a seat, E.
Oh,
gentlemen.
What's up, Ed?
Y'all know Ed?
What's up, man?
Yo, Hotsy, that's Hotsy.
That's Schnoz.
That's Schnoz.
I'm not really realizing how he's supposed to be this outcast. I'm getting a sense that everyone that knows him, everyone that sees him, kind of likes him. So I think it's more internal. I think he's putting that label on himself more so than it being put on him from the outside.
It was nice talking to you guys.
Was it so bad?
No, it wasn't that bad.
It wasn't that bad? What'd you learn from it?
That they talk to me just like I'm someone else, like I'm one of them, kind of.
Yeah. Made you feel comfortable?
Meeting all these people, that's like one plus to it, because then I know that they like me a little bit more, maybe
respect me a little bit more for talking to them because they know I normally wouldn't do that, so I think I got a little respect today.
You went to the assembly, right? Why do you think everyone booed me?
Well, I think because like they were like, give it up for the cheerleaders, and I know a lot of people in the school hate the cheerleaders.
So why did you guys all yell mean at me?
It's because we don't like cheerleaders, so you guys think you're better than everyone else.
I'm probably one of the least confident girls on the team.
I got a lot of people saying like, they don't like cheerleaders.
That's the third time I've heard that today.
They all say the same thing.
Because you're a cheerleader.
I just don't want people to act negatively towards me when I'm trying to do something.
Just be more passionate about it and people will have more respect for you.
Thank you. I'm going to use that advice.
So it's early morning and I thought I could sleep in a little bit later, but Tedra called me and he wanted to get in another practice, I guess. Abby, Eddie, Christine, once you have all arrived, press play. This kind of creeped me out a little bit. I didn't expect to get a little card thing. But now I guess I gotta wait for Abby and Christine before I can see what it is. It's kind of tempting. I kind of just want to hit it myself.
Hello. Oh my God. It's like a secret message.
Yeah, we gotta wait for Abby. Read it.
Where is Abby?
I know.
Abby, get over here! Look it!
We got a little note.
Is it my rehearsal time or is it like...
Yeah, it's my rehearsal
time. I don't know, it's my rehearsal time.
Once you have all arrived, press play.
Okay, I'm gonna press play.
What's up, Abby, Christine, and Eddie? This your boy Soulja Boy Tellin' coming at you. So I hear y'all wanna be hip-hop dancers. Well, you're gonna have to impress me then, because I'm gonna be one of the judges at the competition.
Oh,
and I'll be expecting each of you to show off a hot performance. But I'm not just here to tell you I'm gonna be a judge. I also got some good news for you. You three are gonna be my backup dancers. That's right, I'll be performing at the show, and you'll be performing behind me as a group together. But that's only if y'all good enough. I've sent you an instructional video on how to do the official dance to my hit song, Birdwalk. Watch it, learn it, listen to your coaches, and make it hot. Good luck.
Oh my God!
Stop. Are you like good at this?
That was crazy.
So right now, okay, we're gonna watch Soulja Boy show you what the dance is gonna look like.
This right here is the Birdwalk instructional DVD. First step to the dance is you gotta drop down like so. Drop. Fourth step to the Birdwalk dance is you take your left foot and you lift it up just like that.
I just learned one routine, now I gotta learn another one and
drop, drop, turn.
It's gonna be insane.
So the first move goes like this. One and two and three, four. Go clutch, six. Now do the same thing. And boom, da da boom, look, boom, and up.
Oh.
And punch.
I feel stupid.
Wait,
dancing like a bird.
One, two, three, four. Da da boom.
I think Abby is definitely the strongest.
They're all in the same boat. They're all nervous. They've never really worked with us, so I see that they've got fear, but I see that they want to get this.
Up! One, two, three. One, two, three, four.
You confused me.
I messed it up because I looked at Christine.
I'm looking at you.
When I'm in Chicago, they hollering at what's up,
Joe. The stakes just got a lot higher. Soulja Boy. Three kids who can't dance at all, and one of them's gonna win $10,000. Welcome Welcome back to the MADE Head-to-Head Hip Hop Challenge. Three high schoolers have entered the biggest MADE competition in history in just an hour. They're gonna perform on this stage right here and compete for $10,000. Let's see how they're doing. The kids started training and were quickly surprised to learn they'd also be dancing on stage with one of their judges, the Crank That superstar himself, Soulja Boy Tell Him.
So yesterday at rehearsal, I went there and there was a video.
And all of a sudden I see Soulja Boy and I was like, oh! And he says, I will be a judge at your performance.
And he's performing.
Oh my God.
Wait, you can't drink that. Soulja Boy.
He's gonna judge like our performance.
Oh my God, Eddie.
I'm nervous for Eddie because he's wicked nervous already. So I think the fact that Soulja Boy is gonna be a judge, he's gonna freak out.
Everybody's, you know, so excited about that. Now I know for sure everybody's gonna come.
DC told me that she had to surprise me for today's practice, and I'm kind of freaking out.
Aren't you ready to be a girl?
Voila. Take a look. That's what Miss Abby is gonna dance on stage in, girl.
Yes, honey.
Try one.
Do I have to?
Yeah. Abby's toughest challenge, putting the heels into the mix, just balance. Obviously, she's never, ever danced in heels. How do your shoes fit?
Awkward.
Balancing them. The key way to balance is all in your abs and all in your tush. Bop, 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 push.
That was kind of off though. Mm-hmm.
She's definitely gonna perform in heels because that's really gonna set her apart from all of her other competition.
Yeah. I'm going to slip them.
Boom, 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 boom.
Ah.
Another brother noticed me.
I feel like I'm off balance though. It was pretty crappy today's lesson.
It caught me off balance and I was so used to like doing all the steps in my sneakers and stuff.
Ah, I keep on f***ing it up. All right. Ah, mother f***.
What happened that time?
I lost my balance.
It was right there. It was right there. All you had to do was finish it. That's all you had to do is just finish it. Just stay right there. Don't move. I think Abby is thrown off by the fact that I threw a little wrench into the machine by putting some heels on her. It totally like dwindled her spirit. This is not the Abby I'm used to rehearsing with. I don't know, it's like she just snapped. Bring this back tomorrow, not looking like this. Because we have got to move on. We have to move on, Abby.
I definitely feel like I took like 10 steps back from where I was yesterday.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
What's the matter?
I'm mad tired.
Really? How'd it go? You look terrible. You look terrible. What happened? Tell me.
She's gonna make me dance in heels, a whole routine.
But honey, it's new.
Yeah, that's the point though.
I know,
like, it sucks.
But that's what I'm saying. Don't get down on yourself, because it's something new. Be excited about it.
It's awful.
Abigail,
I'm so tired.
But doesn't it hurt so good when you do that?
Like, no, it hurts like awful. Like, it sucks.
How much of a tomboy was I?
You were a fat tomboy.
No, but I mean, I was a real tomboy. And then once you realize that once you get to that girly girl point, then you can have the best of both worlds.
I'm gonna
stretching hurts. Do you want aspirin? You want the heating pad? What kind?
I'm going to go to bed.
For
I'm
you.
I'm so tired.
Night, I love you.
Night.
Good job, proud of you.
Oi.
And I'm hoping today we're gonna have a really solid rehearsal. And I need her to be passionate.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good.
Ready to get to work?
Yeah.
Before we get going, I have some gear.
Gear?
This is some Xtreme pants.
No.
Yay. This is a beanie. It says
no.
XDF on it.
No.
What do you mean?
No hats.
But you could at least try it on, see how it looks. These are the shoes that I would like for you to wear every time we rehearse. Cool? You haven't even seen the shoes yet.
But they might be gross.
You keep challenging me every time I ask you to do something.
Oh my God, you're so high.
I spent half the day yesterday looking for those shoes.
Half the day?
Why don't you put on the clothes and then we'll just get started.
Okay. He's trying to make me feel guilty by telling me he spent half the day looking for the shoes he gave me, but I don't even feel bad because they're really ugly.
It's slow getting under my skin. I'm going back, back. Wow, she's not even trying. I feel like I'm the only one trying here. Jump to it.
Oh my God, stop, please.
Sit up.
Stop it.
Every complaint that I hear, it's like a tug of war. Boom, boom, that's it. Get your whole body into it.
But it looks awkward.
How am I supposed to work with someone who's constantly complaining?
I'm kind of hesitant to do a lot of things because I don't want to embarrass myself.
So do you not want to do this because you don't think you can?
85% of the school thinks I can't do it.
Well, let's prove them wrong, damn it. I just need you to trust me and change what I ask you to change for the time being. In the end, it's all going to come together. It's all going to make sense.
When I saw the choice of coaches, and I was thinking in my head, like, who I'd want, it wasn't him.
I've got a big plan for today's rehearsal. I mean, he's got a lot of endurance and balance issues, and I'm really going to try to push him today and get a lot done.
So how do you think you're doing?
It hurts a lot.
Your body's going through a lot, right? So what about tomorrow's rehearsal?
Tomorrow's like a big day for my mom. We find out if her cancer treatment's working or not.
Okay.
And, I mean, I'm not sure my mind's going to be in the right place all day tomorrow.
I understand what you're telling me, but I don't want you to use that as an excuse for you to slack off.
Right.
Stand up. You're one. Up. Just like that.
Four, five, six.
Bend your knee. Turn. Okay. Now do it by yourself. Look up. Look up so you can see yourself. That way you'll catch it. Look up.
I'm throwing myself off.
Because you can't see yourself. Every time I need you to look up, you're just going to hear me smack this. Look up and do it. That's the number one thing you need is to be able to look up when you dance.
All right, I gotta take a break.
I don't know, it's falling apart. He probably can't do it.
I just don't wanna do it anymore. I'm gonna cry.
Let me know when you're ready. That's your only break. Feel better? Got it out the system?
I actually just told my mom to come get me.
Why?
Because I'm not really in the mood to do this anymore right now.
Anymore right now? Anymore ever? Because I need to know.
No, I want to do it. I just feel like I need some time to relax.
Eddie, you don't have that option. If you really want this, then you have to sacrifice that to get it.
I'm not. I know, but I've sacrificed a lot already.
What? What have you sacrificed? You don't do after school.
But I walk to school and I walk home. I don't.
You wasn't doing it before. So now what? What was you really doing that was important that you can't do now?
Right at this moment, winning doesn't mean anything to me. I just don't want to do it anymore. Yeah, that's him.
How you doing, Sam?
How you doing?
Good.
All right, how's he doing, all right?
Did he tell you why he was leaving early?
No, he didn't tell me. What happened?
Want to tell your dad why you're leaving early?
You're going to quit. You're just going to quit like that? You're just going to let me down like that now? Now you're pissing me off. You're giving up on me. No one pissed at you. Get in the truck.
Now, we're joined by Eddie's dad, Tom, and mum, Shelley. Welcome, both of you.
How you doing?
Good to have you both here. When you went and pulled up to pick up Eddie, did you think anything was wrong?
No, not at the time, I didn't.
So why'd you get so angry with Eddie?
Cedric come up and told me he quit. And it pissed me off.
Is that the first time he's ever said something like that?
Yeah. First time he ever quit anything. I was like, can I remember? First time.
There you go. Thanks so much. Round of applause. It's time for all three kids to rise to the challenge. Believe me, you don't want to miss a moment of MADE. MADE's first ever head-to-head hip-hop challenge, where three high schoolers are putting their blood, sweat, and tears on the dance floor. We brought back three veteran MADE coaches to train our hopeless dancers. Which one of them will be crowned our hip-hop champion? Only talent will tell. We last saw Eddie walk out of his practice.
I'm not really in the mood to do this anymore.
Both his coach and his dad were disappointed.
No one pissed at you.
But was he out of the competition for good?
No. Why would Eddie drop out?
Do you know why?
Why, Eddie quit?
Yeah.
No. Yeah, apparently. I don't know. I found out like today, like first period, someone was like, oh, Eddie quit. I got like a 50-50 chance now.
Oh, hello, that's so much money. I'd be happy to receive.
I think you're gonna win.
Yeah, that Eddie quit.
I heard. Now it's like just the two of us.
Going down, bitch.
Mm-mm.
Hey!
Hey! Today at school, I heard Eddie dropped out of the competition.
What?
Yeah, that's not a joke. He really did.
That's crazy.
I know, so I have less competition now.
That's good news. Let's kick some butt.
Wait, let's review what we did last time we were together, and then I'm gonna add on and go over some steps.
Okay.
So you're gonna go, the first step is one, two, three.
Oh, come on. That looks so gross.
Yeah, that creates the right move.
Okay, so after that.
Watch how fast it goes. Boom. See how quick that is?
It's ugly.
If it were ugly, I wouldn't give it to you.
But I can't do it, so it's ugly.
It's a power move, I mean.
But for now, can I just do the feet so I get used to it?
Let's do the whole thing so you get used to the whole thing.
Work it, they can't do it.
I'm not standing there going, woo! I'll get on stage and I won't do it.
You gotta just believe that.
Well, I'll just do something else.
Coming up with the perfect routine for you, Christine, is probably...
That's why you should ask for my help.
I was like, oh gosh, here we go again, you know, back in the studio. Same non-work ethic attitude, and she was complaining a lot.
Nope.
I wish that it was important to her. Got lots of work to do.
Okay,
weeks.
You don't have to keep reminding me. I know I suck.
I've seen kids that suck, and you ain't one of them. You actually have a lot of potential, but I've told you that.
Let's do it like this. If you focus, we'll get out of here early.
Take your pants off.
And the shorts.
Yeah, right.
Take the shorts off.
No, come on, Cece.
No, take the shorts. That defeats the purpose of me telling you to wear freaking leggings to rehearsal.
No, it doesn't. I'll roll them up.
What the hell do you think you're wearing on stage?
Not spandex.
Take the shorts off. Get over yourself, girl.
You don't need to see my freaking, like, huge ass thighs. And...
Yeah, and you see my huge ass.
You don't
ass.
Have f-ing huge ass.
Look at my ass. Look at it. Beat your booty. Let's go. Two, three, four, you go.
Good, Abby.
Da, 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 da. Good, good.
You got it, girl.
Seven and eight and one.
Yes.
So I really want her to step up her game and be very, very feminine and be very confident, be a girl.
I think I got it pretty well. I mean, there's no doubt that I still need to practice it. But now that I know what I'm doing, it's just a good feeling.
I'm here with Abby's mom, Catherine, and dad, Dave. Welcome both of you.
Thank you.
How has this whole MADE experience changed? Abby, I saw her for the first time in 4 weeks today. I didn't recognize her.
I think the whole experience has been so positive for her. She's made me so proud.
Dave, is it a welcome change? We see a little bit more makeup, some high heels. Are you happy about it? You look like a big fella. I'll do it like this.
I'd rather see it in 5 years, but she's a pretty girl and I'm very proud of her.
Nicely done. Thanks very much, both of you. Cheers for coming by. Pleasure. Well, time is almost up for our three dancers, but are they ready to perform with Soulja Boy? We'll find out soon. Plus, we'll reveal their once-in-a-lifetime makeovers right here on MADE. Head-to-head hip-hop challenge. We've got girly girls whining, lazy kids quitting, and tomboys burping. But this isn't just another maid. One of these kids is gonna walk away with $10,000. Abby seemed to find her groove, while Christine kept her coach groaning.
I'll get on stage and I won't do it.
Eddie took himself out of the competition, but his mom wasn't ready for him to be done.
Eddie's decision to quit was very upsetting. This is something I really don't want to miss out on. Just, it's a great opportunity for him.
We really just need to consider this.
I have. I've been thinking about it like all weekend.
Is Cedric like giving you too many steps at once?
I feel like I can't keep doing the 2-hour classes every day and then have one day off to recover and then go back and do another 2.5-hour class.
It's such an awesome chance for you to like just to come out of your shell and make all new friends. The family, everybody is behind you like 120%. I don't want you to give it up. I want you to give it one more shot and just do what you know, do the best you can. What I love hearing the stories when you come home. Mm-hmm. It gives me something to look forward to.
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Okay.
Okay?
Hello, good afternoon.
Hey, it's Eddie.
Hey, Ed, what's up?
No, I just wanted to call you to say that I changed my mind and I want to come back.
So if you're really thinking about coming back, we got rehearsal tomorrow.
Well, that was another thing. I wanted to ask you about the rehearsals and just see if there was a way we can, like, minimize some of the hours on it.
I guess if you want to slim down some, I'm not going to rehearse with you Saturday.
Okay.
I'm really happy that you're coming back.
Yeah, I'm happy too.
All right, I'll talk to you tomorrow.
All right.
All right.
Bye.
Guess who's back in the building?
Yay! You're back?
I'm back.
He couldn't stay away too long. He's a dancer.
I'm excited.
Feel a little nervous now, Abby? You got some competition?
I do, actually. I was like, yes!
Damn. All right, y'all.
All right, Miss Abs.
Good night.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Put some spring in your step. 5, 6, 7, 8. Hit. Yes.
I feel like I kind of lose it, though, when I start going.
Are you just practicing?
A little bit.
Like one more time. Hell yeah! Today's practice, Eddie came back. He felt and looked more invested in doing this.
Yes.
And that made it go a whole lot easier. Now you can put a little bit more into it. So we're gonna work with the hat. You're gonna physically move the hat. Right.
I didn't know what to expect coming back into it, but I was really excited to come back. And I think today's rehearsal went really well.
So we're gonna get this done.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to make him really that much better.
We're here with Eddie's mum, Shelley. Very quickly, how has him returning to the competition affected you?
When I first found out he had quit, it bothered me a lot.
Why?
Because I've been sick, and him doing this has given him something to focus on other than me. It just made me really happy. It was good.
Right. Obviously, Eddie, we see it in the show. He's a wonderful son. What's it gonna feel like tonight to be sitting here and see Eddie do what he described to me as one of the hardest things he's ever had to do in his life?
I just hope I don't cry. It's exciting. I can't wait to see it. I just can't wait. It's going to be so much fun to watch.
All right. Thank you so much for being here. You too, Tom.
Thank you.
Heads up.
I am kind of worried about the competition now that Eddie's back in.
I'm so pissed.
Why is he back?
Because, like, you can't just quit and then come back, because obviously you don't really want it. Now I'm probably not going to win.
I don't know. I guess guess we're just gonna have to see what happens.
Cece took me to get more girly clothes because I don't have any.
The clothes that I would normally buy would be located at Dick's Sporting Goods.
This is cute.
Isn't that what adorable? Is it?
It's a dress.
Can we stay away from like the dresses? I'm not squeezing into that.
But we're trying to bring out the girl in you. You have to look beyond the shirt. You have to put things with the shirt. These are skinny jeans. Do you own a pair of skinny jeans?
I don't like skinny jeans.
These would be so cute on you. Just for fun, we're gonna see what it looks like.
I feel so lost.
Ooh, what's that face?
They're too tight.
No, they're not, honey.
Yeah, they are.
These things look good on you. Oh my God. You have a body, Abby. Where did that booty come from? She's gonna look good. I'm excited.
I definitely have to get used to the clothes because they're definitely not what I'm used to.
I'm here tonight at Christine's football game. She talks about cheerleading a lot, and I know cheerleading is very important to her, and I'm here to kind of mend things to let her know that I support her and that I believe in her. Looks like she's having a lot of fun out there.
He's here and I hate him. Why is he here?
Hey, Christine! Christine!
Tell him to shut the hell up.
You look adorable!
Thank you.
It was really, really nice to walk up and see a girl. She looked great. She's actually in jeans that fit her, so it was really, really nice to see that.
Hey, look, I got flyers for you guys.
Soulja Boy?
Yeah. I'm here at the football game to pass out flyers promoting the final event and promote David Archuleta's new CD, which is in stores now.
He's such a good boy.
I know. If he was here, he would like it.
He loves you.
Yeah,
don't worry. He loves you.
And I'm doing a hip-hop dance, and, like, I'm going to be there. Soulja Boy will be there. And it's free to go, so if you want to go, it's free.
Hi, Cedric.
What about that group? Right at the top. I think they need to know about a flyer or two.
There you go, Abby.
Thanks, Eddie. Cedric! What up?
She here again? Uh-huh. I didn't even recognize you.
Abby! Abby! Did you see this? I'm angry about this. Why aren't our names on it?
He's just promoting himself.
Why don't you guys make some flyers like this?
No. You kidding me?
I'm all out of flyers. I'm all out. Within the first, like, 10 minutes, I was all out of flyers. Everyone wanted one. Everyone wanted me to win. Excuse me. I have to just be able to go out there and talk to people, and that's exactly what I did. So tonight was a really big learning experience for me. Really cool watching you do your thing.
Yeah.
Good job.
Thanks. Come on, Rose.
Right now, I have group practice with Abby and Eddie. I don't really want to be here because I don't want to see Sam.
We chose to have this rehearsal on a stage so that they would know what it's like to perform on stage and to have an audience. Every minute's going to count because it has to be performance ready.
So if it's 16, they can walk in for 8 and then do the Yule for 8.
If it hits the music. Let's see it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do it again.
Oh, I don't know how to do this.
You don't know how to do this?
No.
It's this. Shoulder. Shoulder, switch, shoulder, shoulder. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and hit.
What are you confused on?
Everything. Like, there's nothing I'm not confused about.
Freestyle on that. When I say freestyle, it's kind of your own thing. Y'all should probably know that, though.
I don't know how to freestyle.
Walk out on the stage as if you were walking out for a cheerleading competition. And Ed's just cool, so he's going to walk out and be ready and then just start it.
I can't walk out and be cool.
Can you pull it off? Because you're asking me how to walk out, so
for
you gotta
show.
Give me something. You're on your own for your entrance. There you go. Good. Why does it look like Abby's the only one that knows what she's doing? First note I saw, though, I wanna give you guys, it was dead. Bring your energy up.
It's all about energy. You have to have just dumb energy.
All right, let's go again.
We should have these freestyling. Like, who the hell
I'm
a
beat Christine. I'm a beat her. I'm a beat her.
She's all over the stage. Stop.
Don't just walk out on stage,
Christina.
Excuse me?
This is exactly
Christine
what you did.
Christine with an E.
Oh, excuse me, Christine. Miss Christine.
I don't know what to do.
Right. Sam, give us something. That's what I said. Do your natural cheerleader moves. Do what you feel comfortable doing.
People will laugh at me again.
If they're laughing at you, then what do you really care about? You were performing or someone laughing at you? Because they booed you. So if you cared about them booing you, then you don't really need to care about them laughing at you. You're a dancer now. But you're not gonna make us look bad and you're not gonna make yourself look bad because you feel away.
I'm not gonna make anyone look bad.
But you need to stop with this and give me more dancing.
Okay.
All right. From the top.
The beginning today of rehearsal was really rough. They were off in their timing. There's a bad mix.
Let's do it again. Nice effort, Abby. There you go. Now I'm feeling a little something. You're gonna go all the way to the end of the song. It's your marathon bird walk. Good job.
I got to work with Christine a little bit better today, and I don't know how she feels about me personally, but I think that I, you know, helping her, she got it.
He's an ass. I guess Sam isn't so bad. Now that I've worked with Cece and Cedric, I kind of appreciate him a little bit more.
These kids are giving it their all, but is that enough? Whose life is gonna change for the $10,000 grand prize? Stick around and find out. We've got more MADE on the way. Welcome back to MADE, head-to-head hip-hop challenge. Now, for the past 4 weeks, this competition has consumed the lives of our three high schoolers. And right now, the intensity couldn't be higher and the stakes couldn't be greater. But the big question is, who's gonna win the $10,000? Let's see how they're doing.
Hey, Christine.
Now I appreciate Sam a lot more after seeing, like, the other coaches. Cedric.
But you need to stop with this and give me more dancing.
I think he's very rude and mean and too serious. So I'm, like, thankful that he's not my coach.
I pick my knees up and I go, knee, knee. Now watch what happens. This leg comes up and joins this one. And they shoot out. Seven and eight. Yeah. Come, bring your shoulders down though, and you go back. You know what I mean?
Down like this.
Like, yeah, come down to your knees. It's up here. It doesn't look as good.
Like...
Yeah, right. Better. Here we go. Energy, energy, energy.
That is energy.
Energy, energy, energy.
That's how it should be done.
I'm very impressed. And we just need to keep working hard.
Sam was surprised, and he was happy. Abby's more in my competition than Eddie, but I guess we'll just see at the final event who rocks it and who doesn't.
There we go.
Oh my God, it's cold.
I think it's on the other side.
164, wait, it's 232.
Oh, we should cross the street.
We were given an assignment by the coaches to come to downtown Boston.
What's the number?
235.
I have absolutely no idea why we are here.
I'm really scared because I don't know what's gonna happen.
Oh, no.
We're getting a makeover.
Maybe we get like face masks.
No, thank you.
You understand what's happening tonight, right?
Yeah, we're giving you a makeover.
You got the skills, now you're gonna have the look.
I'm pretty pumped for it. I wanna see what they can do with all this up here.
Damn, I like that poof.
Thank you.
Let's go see what they look like.
Oh boy.
Oh!
You guys! Oh my God!
Look at where you get all of this! Ed, that's crazy.
Yes, honey.
That is crazy, yeah.
I definitely feel more confident now. I'm like really excited for Thursday.
She has a lot of confidence now. I mean, she looks great. Like, wow.
I feel great right now. I love my new hair. And she's gonna sling that hair and she's gonna look fierce.
You look real good, man.
I'm looking forward to our next rehearsal even more just because now I can do it with my new hair.
I can tell the confidence in him from him thinking that because I look different, I should act different.
You guys are awesome. Thank you so much.
I love it.
Can I touch it?
Yeah.
Do you love it?
I do.
Oh, sweetie, it looks great.
Yeah.
Bye, Mom.
Bye. Just hope people respond good to it and they like it.
Harvey! Oh my God, you look so pretty.
Thank you.
Whoa.
You're looking fresh.
You look nice.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even recognize you.
Oh my God, did you dye your hair? Okay. You just saying that to be nice?
No, I really like it.
You look adorable.
Thank
you. I just wanna.
Oh, thank
you. That looks hot.
His confidence definitely has changed a lot. It's just another step in him like changing and being the new Eddie that we all want him to be.
Abby! Like, who are you?
Feel it.
Feel it.
Are you nervous for the big day?
Yeah, I'm like my pants.
Wait, where are you with Abby t-shirts?
Yeah, by the popcorn machine.
Winthrop High School Drama Society will be selling t-shirts to support Eddie, Abby, and Christine.
To color her red because she's gonna slaughter the competition.
I'm so getting pumped.
I want that one.
You are the first Christine t-shirt sold.
So Christine has 30 t-shirts left and Abby has 28. Eddie has none. Completely sold out this morning, which is really good.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's not a little margin. That's a pretty big margin to have none to 30. So it's pretty intense.
This is our last group rehearsal.
We gotta make sure this bird walk dance looks really, really good.
It's all about perfection today. You have to do it like you're doing it for Soulja Boy himself. Because you are doing it for Soulja Boy himself.
What up, what up, what
oh
up, what
God.
Up, what up? Soulja Boy is in the building.
How you doing, Soulja Boy? What's good?
Hi.
Soulja Boy.
Nice to meet you.
How you doing?
Hi.
Soulja Boy.
Y'all supposed to be performing with me, right? So, on a scale from 1 to 10, where do you think you at right now?
I'm gonna try 10.
10?
Right. I'll be honest, I say 7.
7?
12.
12? Ooh. He thinks he's a 7. What you think he is?
10.
10. She thinks she's a 10. What you think she is?
9.
He's honest. He's spinning the truth. He's spinning the truth right here.
Eddie!
Oh, y'all ready to show me what y'all got?
Music, please.
Squalla.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Soulja Boy,
oh,
tell
yeah. Him. Oh, yeah.
Y'all know what it is. That's enough. Now, honestly, what I think, that was pathetic. Like, just to tell y'all the truth, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you're not adding no emotion to it. It looked like the bird walk being done by a stick man. You gotta add, like, your own, like, you know what I'm saying, drop, you know what I'm saying? Like, your own moves with it, you feel what I'm saying? I mean, it's a real big deal because I don't just let anybody perform with me on stage, you know what I'm saying? So I'ma personally work with each one of y'all one by one so y'all can get a good feel of what I'm talking about. All you gotta do is just do this motion right there and just drop, drop, drop. There, right there.
He touched me.
Step forward just a little bit with it.
I'm a little overwhelmed, Soulja Boy's here, and you know, it's crazy.
I like that, man.
Thank you.
I like that. It's advanced.
I'm thinking that's going to be a good thing for them. I like the fact that he took his time out to make sure that they got the dance down right.
Oh, only two. Right.
Bounce. Bounce. See? That's how you're supposed to do it.
Good. We're good.
Thank you.
We're good right there. Y'all better than when I first came in, but I still think that y'all need a little bit more swag. These my official Soulja Boy Tell 'em shoes right here. If this don't help y'all out with your swag, I don't know what will. I'm out.
Reach for the stars!
What we would rate each other, why did you rate me a 9?
Oh, I don't know, just being different. Everyone else is being so nice.
So you picked me to be mean to?
I'm sorry. Do you want a hug?
No.
Okay. Oh, good job selling all your t-shirts, by the way.
Yeah? Yeah? Good job losing $10,000! Oh, what now?
I'll see you tonight. Ugh, kiss my ass.
This is our last one-on-one.
Glad to have hear me yell at you.
Well, look who decided to show up today.
I'm impressed. You're here, ready to work.
Being that this is our last one-on-one, I'm just looking for him to bring up some energy and to really give me a performance. Here we go.
Stand up!
Get into it.
Okay.
Stand up.
Abby is the strongest out of the three. I just don't want her to get comfortable in that, and I really want her to work it.
Xtreme really pulled herself together. I see the want in her. I think she wants this now.
Yes.
Just like that. Stand up.
I can't even begin to say how I feel about how Eddie's done and come so far.
Good job, man. That's what I want. That's what I want.
I'm feeling the best I've ever felt this whole time. Like, Abby and Christina are gonna have trouble keeping up with me because I'm gonna give them a run for their money.
You look really, really good. I'm so excited. I cannot wait to hear what the judges are gonna even say about it.
No matter what the judges may think, you've already won this competition because you've accomplished everything you set out to do.
I think you're gonna look great. No matter what the audience does or says, you keep going.
I'm nervous, getting a little bit scared, but it should be good.
The transformations are complete. The cheerleader, the jock, and Eddie have all become hip-hop dancers. But when we come back, all three will be competing for $10,000.
Don't go anywhere.
ready time.
Ready time.
I'm here.
He helped me before, this little pen.
You look nervous, buddy.
I am. I'm just a little bit nervous.
A little bit? You look the part.
Thank you. Is that for me?
Everything you need to do is right now. Everything you need to do. Go ahead and get to your place.
Right. You got it? You got it?
No turning back now. I gotta just go.
Welcome back to the first ever MADE head-to-head hip-hop challenge. We've witnessed the journey of three kids who have studied hip-hop for 4 weeks. But can they take what they've learned and become $10,000 richer? Well, the wait is over. It's time for them to bring it to the dance floor and impress this audience, you guys at home, and our three celebrity judges. This choreographer worked with Michael Jackson. Please welcome Chris Judd. And of course, you guys know this choreographer making the band, Laurie Ann Gibson. And please make some noise for hip-hop superstar, Soulja Boy. The decision is all in their hands. Judges will decide who wins the Big Ten Grand based on style, technique, and confidence. And in a few, Soulja Boy is going to perform his brand new single, Bird Walk, right here on stage. Now first up, let's just recap the transformations that have taken place in the last 4 weeks. Eddie started out as a shy kid who mostly kept to himself. He was, let's be honest, lazy and took cabs to school every day. Eddie almost didn't make it through the competition.
I've sacrificed a lot already.
What? What have you sacrificed? You don't do after school.
He quit, but after talking it over with his mom,
give it one more shot and just do the best you can.
He got back in the game.
Hell yeah.
Did his return come too late? We're about to find out. Let's welcome Eddie's coach. Make some noise for Cedric. How are you, pal?
I'm good.
Now we have a lot of Eddie fans in the audience.
Word, make some noise.
Did you think he was gonna come back, let alone take to the stage tonight?
Honestly, I didn't know if he was gonna come back. Eddie decided to make a decision as a man, and I stuck with him. When he came back, he turned it around and became so much better at what he's doing.
All right. So listen, who better to make this introduction than you? Introduce your boy, Eddie.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight you're about to see a damn show that's gonna get you up on your feet. So get up! Get up! Get up! And here for Eddie E. Dog.
Whiskey double because the girls of the world ain't nothing but trouble. They like a little danger. They might not admit it, but they are for the chase and they want us to come and get it.
I know what they feel because I'm breathing on the hills. And this mean they wanna kill
me. Luna!
Yes! Do you recognize him? You're about to get judged.
Eddie, man, I just gotta say that you got on stage and I gotta congratulate you for not quitting. For 4 weeks of trying to get this dance down and especially dancing in front of everyone, you did your thing. And I'm proud of you and I'm sure your mom and dad is proud of you.
Eddie, you can be in one of my videos anytime! From the chess piece all the way through. You were fearless, you were confident. This is not the last time we're gonna see Eddie, okay?
Okay, Soulja Boy.
Eddie, man, all I gotta say is this right here.
Eddie!
Eddie.
All right, thank you very much, judges. Eddie, come over here. My man, welcome. How proud are you of him right now, and how proud are you of yourself?
4 weeks ago when I met Eddie, he was just Eddie. Tonight on this stage, he became E-Dub in front of everybody.
There you go. And no doubt, you're very proud of yourself right now. How did it feel performing?
It felt really good. I wanted to show you guys, but you needed to see it for yourself that I can really do it. So thank you guys for coming.
All right, give it up one more time for Eddie and his coach Cedric. Eddie gave it his best shot, but stick around because we have two more performances on the way. Abby and Christine are gonna take to this stage right here. Stick around for more of MADE's head-to-head hip-hop challenge.
And that's it. That's all you had to do. How you feeling?
I'm feeling really good.
Real good. Christine, kill him, you can do it.
Man, I'm so proud of you. You really did it.
You know they save the best for last, right?
Maybe.
Eddie!
Hi,
Let me just tell you, I did the best I've ever done, so.
Nice.
Whew, I need a seat after that one.
I don't want to go last.
Welcome back to the MADE Head-to-Head Hip Hop Challenge. We just saw Eddie give his best, but can Abby and Christine bring the heat to Lynn Auditorium? It's now or never.
But first, let's see where Christine was 4 weeks ago. Christine started off as the clumsy cheerleader who wanted people to take her seriously. She had a lot to overcome. She was booed from the start, and she hated her coach.
Oh my God, stop.
But after a tough group lesson,
you need to stop with this and give me more dancing.
She decided to patch things up with Sam, change her attitude, and pull herself together. Will it all pay off? We'll see how she does.
Let's meet Christine's coach, Sam. Well, Sam has a lot of fans in the audience. Slow down. Sam,
Yes. Was
it hard work working with Christine?
It was very hard work, but it's all about to pay off right now.
Why was she such a hard student?
Well, you know, there was a little bit of whining here and there, but I think it came to an end, and I think she's going to show everybody what she really, really can do as a hip-hop dancer.
Okay. Team Christine is in the building. The last words of advice for the girl.
I think as long as Christine focuses, she can do anything she wants, but she's got to focus.
Okay, here you go. Who better to do it than you? Time to introduce your cheerleader turned hip-hop dance.
I want everybody in this building to get off their feet right now. I want to see how loud can this place get. Christine, give it up, give it up, give it up.
Time to get judged. Chris.
Congratulations, you did a great job. You had really cool style, and especially I liked how you're like doing all those moves on the floor. You're trying some difficult stuff. So, good job.
Thank you, Chris. Lorianne.
Okay, little muffin, you know, I can be a little tough. I really liked that you used your technique. You got down, the knee slide was hot, so you threw in some really technical moves there. Kudos to you, proud of you. Just loosen it up a little bit. Little tight in some areas. You're definitely stronger, definitely stronger.
Great feedback. Now, Soulja Boy, she had a tough audience to win over. What do you think?
If you came from being booed in front of your whole entire school to dancing once again in front of the same people who just got through booing you, that's a big step right there. I can see the confidence in your eyes, and I like the way you did that. Good job.
There you go. Thank you very much, Soulja Boy. No one's booing anymore. How do you feel right now?
I feel absolutely amazing. I was, like, really scared, but as much as I complained through the past 3 weeks, like, it was so worth it. I'm excited.
Give it up, Christine and Sam.
Wow. Somewhere where the judges were at.
We've got our third and final performer on the way.
But let's take a look back to see how far she's come. Abby started off as the goofy jock who wanted to be more girly and graceful. Her friends and family laughed at her goal.
and her coach was completely grossed out by her hygiene.
You need to shave your legs.
She had to master dancing in heels and get over her fear of spandex.
Look at my ass, look at it.
But was it enough to become a hip hop hottie, or is she still just one of the guys? It's time to find out.
Let's welcome, give it up, Abby's coach, Cece. Well, hello, Cece. How are you, love?
Hi, how are you?
Everyone say hello to Cece. How has Abby grown in the last 4 weeks?
Abby has grown tremendously. She looks amazing.
Have you managed to get her to stop burping and cursing?
No, I think that's Abby.
One step at a time. 4 weeks was all you had. We don't blame you for it. Tonight, we're going to see her performing in heels.
Yes.
Has she ever owned a pair of heels before?
No, Abby owns no heels. She stole her sister's heels to wear to school.
So, Cece, everyone here knows what time it is. It's your turn to do the honors.
First of all, stand up. This is my girl, Abby. She's my little queen, and I love her, and she's gonna show you something tonight.
Give it up for Abby. Okay, we've got tears in the front. Chris, what do you think of her style and her performance?
You know, I just think from being an athlete to coming on stage, you absolutely just turned into a superstar. And you have the potential of being a professional dancer if you want to pursue it. And for dancing in heels for the first time is such a feat unto itself. What was the capper was throwing the ring to Soulja Boy here. That just, it was hot, it was hot.
She's a player now, we've created a monster.
Player, player.
Lorianne.
Abster, I'm gagging, you were flawless. First of all, not only did you dance, but you had props. You look like a movie star, Honey Bunch. Cece, I love that you turned her into Sassafras, 10 points. And again, Tim, everyone tonight is just amazing. And for me, each of them are complete winners in their own right. And there is a gotcha gotcha. Beyonce is an R&B song. And again, we would have liked to see a little more hip hop because Eddie stuck to it and Christina came out here and followed the language. So we do have to respect that. And Abby, you were a little short of actual hip-hop language, but good job overall.
All right, thanks, Lorianne. Now, Soulja Boy.
She made it rain with the money. She had the chair. She walked in heels when she never walked in heels before. I think she lived up to the swag of Beyonce. Good job.
How proud are you of yourself right now? How are you feeling performing in front of everyone? You have such a huge fan base.
It feels absolutely amazing. It's just incredible to like take the energy from the crowd.
And you have anything to say to your many, many fans in the audience right now?
I love you guys so much. Thanks for coming, I really appreciate it.
Make some noise for Cece and Abby. Thank you both. You just saw our three kids giving it everything they've got, but can they handle performing with that man over there, Soulja Boy? That's right, it's coming up next, and it's going to be explosive. And later, we'll crown the first ever MADE head-to-head hip-hop champion. We're getting closer to awarding that $10,000 prize. Stay right here for the all-new MADE.
I got negative feedback from Lorianne. She said I was too tight.
So what? Don't worry about who likes it and who doesn't. As long as you liked it,
I loved it.
Then that's all you need to worry about. Rock, you got this Soulja Boy thing next. No more pressure. Put it in.
Checking out MADE's head-to-head hip-hop challenge. Now, we just saw Abby, Eddie, and Christine in their unforgettable performances live on this stage here in Lynn Auditorium. But now, we really want to put them to the test. Can they keep up with a real hip-hop superstar? Want to find out? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, performing his new hit, Birdwalk, make some noise for Soulja Boy! Put your hands up! Put your hands up! Amazing. You weren't too bad either. Nicely done. Keep it right here. We're just moments away from crowning our first ever MADE head-to-head hip-hop champion. Do this.
Don't go anywhere.
Head-to-head hip-hop challenge. All three of our kids have just performed, not once, but twice, in front of our audience, you all at home, and the judges. So let's just recap the transformations that have taken place in the last 4 weeks. Eddie,
you wanted to become a hip-hop dancer to become more outgoing and to make your mum, who's battling cancer, proud.
You had a ton of crowd support right here from everyone. And Lorianne said you could be in any one of her videos anytime. Will you take home the 10 grand? Christine,
you decided to learn hip-hop to prove you could work hard and earn some respect.
Soulja Boy said you took a big step and he saw the confidence in your eyes. But did he like it enough to crown you the winner? We'll find out soon enough. Abby,
you wanted to show more of your feminine side and get guys to notice you.
Chris Judd said you had the potential to be a professional dancer, but is that enough? to win the grand prize. It's all come down to this final moment on MADE's head-to-head hip-hop challenge. In third place, we have Xtreme. Big round of applause for Xtreme and Sam. Well, now it's down to Abby and Eddie. It could go either way. The winner of the first ever MADE head-to-head hip-hop challenge is... Make some noise for Eddie! Tell me, how are you feeling right now?
I don't even know what to say. I just gotta thank everybody who was here for me. That's amazing. I'm so like...
Did you think you had a chance to win it?
I had no idea that I could win it, but I mean, Cedric did it all for me. I gotta thank Cedric for everything.
What was the biggest challenge you had to go through this entire process?
I think the hardest part was when I quit and came back. I knew I had to prove myself, and I think I did a pretty damn good job.
I think you did too. Soulja Boy, bring it through. There you go, officially certified. But listen, that's not all. We're gonna award you with a check each for $1,000. Thank you very much, Chris. Lorianne, hold the checks up high. It's been so much fun. A big shout out to our MADE coaches, to our judges, and of course, you guys at home. Thank you all for tuning in. Good night.
Throughout my whole experience in MADE, I changed a lot. Now I'm more girly. You know, I feel better about myself.
I definitely feel like this experience is worth more than $10,000. I can be comfortable in other things where I'm not usually comfortable. CeCe taught me that, so I appreciate it.
You look great.
Thank you.
One of the things I learned from me being MADE was that I can really do anything I want to do.
I'm really proud of my performance because everyone cheered for me and people didn't boo me. 4 weeks ago, I couldn't do that.
Eddie! Can I just like take this real quick?
This is the most exciting moment of my life when I had my family on stage with me. I learned that you can't doubt yourself ever. You just have to be able to do it, so. I don't know, I'm a loss for words right now. 10,000, oh my God.
Oh. You're supposed to block it.
Oh my God, I could kill you.
You have a brum, I have a pole.
Fine, I'll take the pole.
No.
My God.
I used to take karate, you know.
Did you? So did I. Eddie, grab something, grab the axe or something.
I'm not getting into this. Oh, I'll let you guys kill each other.
Hey everyone, you just saw us get MADE into hip-hop dancers.
But there's way more stuff online that you didn't get to see.
You know, kick your butt.
Try to make your toes touch the floor.
So check it out now on MADE.MTV.com.